The road season is over, and as we move towards the colder months, you might fancy giving cyclocross a go. It is one of the most accessible forms of bike racing. It's brilliant fun, and it's also relatively safe. But what do you need to do to get your new bike ready to race? Here are some simple things to do. Now, before we jump into this video, remember to like and subscribe if you're enjoying these videos and you want to see more from us. Okay, before we go and buy a new bike, you might already have something that's just ready to do the job for you. Local cyclocross races are far more relaxed about what you rock up on. So if you've already got a gravel bike or a mountain bike, you can just grab that. This saves you investing in a whole new bike just to give a cyclocross a go, which is one of the reasons that Cross is brilliant. But we're big fans of buying new bikes here at road.cc, so obviously we'd encourage you to go out and buy a new whip. Once you've got it home, it's time to set it up. And just like any other bike, we'll need to get your bum and your hands in the right position. Tackling saddle height first, you simply want to replicate the saddle height that you'd use on your road bike. You can also use the saddle height that you use on your gravel bike or mountain bike. If you're using different shoes and pedals to what you'd use, say, on a road bike, then try to account for the different stack heights of those systems. You should also be keeping roughly the same saddle setback as you use for your road bike. The only exception, I'd say, would be if you're running your saddle massively forward on your road bike. This wouldn't be ideal in cyclocross because we're looking to get your weight nicely distributed over the bike for better handling. You don't really want to be super low at the front end for aero, doesn't really matter that much. And that moves us nicely on to handlebars. Start with your road position, or as close as you can get, as you'll be already comfortable in that. If your road position is set up to be low at the front end for those juicy aero gains, then again, I'd go ahead and just do the following changes straight off the bat. Off-road riding isn't as fast as on the road, and where the key thing of road riding is pushing air out of the way, cyclocross is all about staying upright, so handling is the main focus here. As such, my cyclocross bar position is always about 1 to 2 centimeters higher than my road bike, and the bars are about a centimeter closer to me too. The taller and shorter position just makes it easier to deal with technical terrain, be that rough surfaces or tight corners, but there is also a second benefit. As you start slogging your way through a muddy field, this position will also be a fair bit kinder to your back. And while we're up at the front end, consider the position of your levers. I'd advise against tucking them right down where many road racers have them, as again, control on difficult terrain can be lost. Instead, move them the other way slightly. This might take a little bit of trial and error, but you should eventually find what is comfortable for you. Once you're comfortable on your cyclocross bike, it's time to dive into tyre choice. The right rubber is key to getting traction, so I'd really encourage you to consider a tyre upgrade if the ones that came on your bike aren't up to the job. There are several tread patterns out there, but they will generally break down into three categories. First are the dry tyres. These will have a file tread in the centre and maybe some slightly shorter shoulder knobs. They're great for sandy courses too. Then we have intermediate tyres. These will be covered with a low profile tread, and often this is what manufacturers will plump for when selecting stock tyres. You can easily run these tyres throughout a season of racing, just get ready to lower your tyre pressure down a lot when it gets muddy. Finally, we've got mud tyres. These have tall, widely spaced knobs to bite into the mud and then clear quickly. That comes at the cost of straight line speed though. So my favourite setup, for my riding anyway, is to have a mud tyre on the front for cornering grip and then to use an intermediate on the rear tyre. You generally have a better chance of saving a rear end slide than if your front wheel goes. So if you want to save some rolling resistance, then the rear wheel is the place to do it. You can run inner tubes if you like, but tubeless really makes sense in cyclocross as it significantly reduces the risk of punctures at low pressures, and running low pressures is what is going to give us that precious grip. Cyclocross seems to be the last frontier for the tubular tyre, and keen racers will generally use them once they start taking racing quite seriously. A tubular is stitched close around an inner tube. This is then glued onto a tubular specific rim. And the advantages are that you can run the lowest pressures without risking the tyre coming off. They generally behave the best when cornering too, but we're getting a bit too deep into the details here. If you're just starting out, then tubeless is what we'd suggest. That leads us nicely onto tyre pressure. Even a mud tyre will struggle to grip if you put too much air in, so getting this right is crucial. Thankfully, and I'm about to get sciencey here, there is a formula to get you in the ballpark when picking a pressure. First, you'll need your weight in pounds. For me, that is 139, and divide it by 10 to get 13.9. Then add 5 if you're using tubulars, 10 for tubeless and 20 for clinchers. I've got tubeless here, so my starting point can be 23.9 PSI, well, 24 for an easy life. The conditions that you're riding in can influence this too. In very muddy conditions where there are very few roots and rocks, I'll drop that pressure by around 5 PSI to say 19 PSI. If I was riding in quite rough or dry conditions, then I'd want to protect the rims from impact, so I'd add about 5 PSI to the original value, taking it up to about 29 PSI. That's my range. You can also consider the different loads that the two wheels are taking and add a little to the rear to compensate for the added load bearing it does. Oh, and one thing to note, if you're using tubular or tubeless, it's fine to be able to feel the wheel rim contacting the ground occasionally. But for clinchers, I wouldn't want that. The wheels that those tyres sit on will ideally be nice and wide to support the sidewalls of those wide tyres. Both carbon and aluminium wheels are great for cross, and for me, the sweet spot of the rim is going to be about 30 to 40 millimetres deep. If you're going to be doing quite a bit of accelerating out of corners, you don't really want anything deeper because it's likely to feel sluggish. And my final point, which won't surprise you if you've watched a few of our videos, is to keep your drivetrain squeaky clean like this one is. Oh, and contrary to what you might expect for this discipline, which usually happens in the muck, you need the lightest chain lube possible. It's not just for the looks this time either. Heavy winter chain lubes or wet lubes do a brilliant job of protecting your chain, but they also do a great job of collecting dirt. Over the course of a muddy ride or race, this can build up and eventually your chain will start to misbehave. Start with a fully stripped chain and cassette and chain rings. Remove the chain if it's still coated in packing grease and treat it to bath in white spirit. Rinse dry and then reinstall before applying a light coat of extra light lube or chain wax. Wipe off any excess and then leave to dry before you ride. Yes, you will have to wash and re-lube after every ride, but I'll happily do that in exchange for gears that are working in the last 10 minutes of a race, because no, I don't have another bike to grab from the pits. So there are our key tips for getting your cyclocross bike ready to race. Like I said, if you've already got a gravel bike, you just turn up on that. You don't need to invest into something new. But once you do get out there, I really hope you have a great time. It's my favourite discipline of cycling, so I hope you have a blast too. If you've liked this video, then remember to like it and subscribe for more. If you've got any top tips of your own, pop them down in the comments section because it might help someone else out. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.